Stehle, the detective Stehle.
Oh, I like that.
He is lots of great. He's a guy who used to always do these detective shows. Thank you.
Greetings and welcome to you all, to all who have come this evening to celebrate this very special occasion in the life of our cathedral parish. Tonight, we thank God for allowing us to gather in His name and to celebrate the artistic, the pastoral, and the musical achievement of this completed great organ, tuned for praise and thanksgiving. We honor the memory and commitment of those whose vision 35 years ago imagined a pipe organ that could truly fill this space and lift hearts and minds to heaven. An instrument that could call forth the song that is in every human heart, yearning to be sung. We honor those who have recently re-energized that vision by supporting its long-awaited completion, who made a commitment to future generations of worshipers and those who appreciate music that inspires, edifies, and brings joy. We are truly grateful for your presence tonight and encourage you to enter into the spirit of the celebration by your hearty responses in song and speech. And so we now pray. Blessed be you, O God, who gave the birds their song, the whales their hum, the lions their roar, and the oceans their beat.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be you for tuning the soul to the rhythms and songs of praise that fill your creation.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be you for poets and prophets who have honored your word in ecstatic speech and faithful proclamation.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be you for composers, singers, and instrumentalists who have attended to your spirit, drawing music from the silent alleluias of the heart, shaping breath and sound to the glory of your name.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be you for congregations who have filled their lives with faith and their voices with song.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed be you for every creature who joins to proclaim how great is your name in all the earth.
Blessed be God forever.
And blessed are you who have brought us to this day when we can praise and thank you for the gift of music in this cathedral parish and for the unique gift of this fully realized and completed pipe organ.
Blessed be God forever.
Thank you. A reading from the first book of Chronicles. They brought in the ark of God and set it inside the tent that David had pitched for it. And they offered burnt offerings and offerings of well-being before God. When David had finished offering the burnt offerings and the offerings of well-being, he blessed the people in the name of the Lord, and he distributed to every person in Israel, man and woman alike, to each a loaf of bread, a portion of meat, and a cake of raisins. He appointed certain of the Levites as ministers before the ark of the Lord, to invoke, to thank, and to praise the Lord, the God of Israel. Asaph was to sound the cymbals, and the priests Benaiah and Jehazel were to blow the trumpets regularly before the ark of the covenant of God. Then on that day, David first appointed the singing of praises to the Lord by Asaph and his kindred. O give thanks to the Lord, call on his name, make known his deeds among the peoples. Sing to him, sing praises to him, tell of all his wonderful works. Glory in his holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Seek the Lord and his strength. Seek his presence continually. Remember the wonderful works he has done, his miracles, and the judgments he uttered. O offspring of his servant Israel, children of Jacob, his chosen ones, he is the Lord our God. His judgments are in all the earth. Remember his covenant forever, the word that he commanded for 1,000 generations, the covenant that he made with Abraham, his sworn promise to Isaac. The word of the Lord.
Any music you hear is made up of time and tone and energy. But there is far more going on than physics. Music needs an initiator and a responder. It is a language sent and received. And for us as humans, it is as varied as our human societies. Each Aboriginal tribe developed its own language, customs, beliefs, and art forms. In music, sounds of nature provided the model. Wind and water, birds, fish, animal. Imitating these sounds, primitive people explored their own voices and body sounds, inventing instruments to extend the possibilities. Flutes and drums of all kinds are common to early societies. Humans have to learn through their senses, and the arts are exaltations of those senses.
So, remember, just as the body of Jesus Christ was born by the Holy Spirit from the spotless Virgin Mary, so too the singing in the church of God's praise, which is an echo of the harmony of heaven, has its roots in that same Holy Spirit. But the body is the garment of the soul, and it is the soul which gives life to the voice. That is why the body must raise its voice in harmony with the soul for the praise of God. God should be praised with the crashing cymbals, with cymbals of clear praise, and with all the other musical instruments that clever and industrious people have produced. For all the arts serving human desires and needs are derived from the breath that God sent into the human body. And that is why it is fitting that God be praised in all.
Sing unto the Lord a new song. The Psalter enjoins us again and again. It is the Christ hymn, new every morning, that the family fellowship strikes up at the beginning of the day. The hymn that is sung by the whole Church of God on earth and in heaven, and in which we are summoned to join. God has prepared for himself one great song of praise throughout eternity, and those who enter the community of God join in this song. It is the song that the morning stars sang together, and the sons of daughters of God shout for joy at the creation of the world. It is the victory song of the children of Israel after passing through the Red Sea, the Magnificat of Mary after the Annunciation, the song of Paul and Silas in the night of prison, the song of the singers on the sea of glass after their rescue, the song of Moses, the servant of God, and the song of the Lamb. It is the new song of the heavenly fellowship.
My name is Tom Stehle. I have the privilege and the honor to serve this cathedral community as the Pastoral Associate for Liturgy and as the Director of Music Ministries. As you can see, there will be a collection taken up now, and if you can be generous, we'd very much support you, appreciate your support for all of the concerts that are going to be following this one, starting in September with the dedicatory recital with Nathan Laube, who is a wonderful organist who is all the rage these days, and we have him in September to play this marvelous instrument. Celebrations such as these do not just happen without dedicated souls who, mostly behind the scenes, dream and work and sacrifice on our behalf. And so I would like to mention some very special people who are with us tonight. First of all, when this organ that you now see completed was barely a thought, was really not even conceived yet, the then director of music, Dr. Gerald Muller, and his organist, Jay Rader, and Bob Gallagher, also who I believe is here this evening, they put their minds together. There's a history there listed in your program. But they had a vision for, I hope, what we just experienced. An organ such as this, beautiful to look at, but even more magnificent in sound. And I'd like to ask Dr. Muller and Jay and Bob Gallagher, wherever you are, to stand so that we could acknowledge your presence and what you did for us. Without that vision, we would not be here tonight, and we would not enjoy this beautiful, complete instrument for the rest of our lives and the life of this parish. So we are so grateful to them. I also want to acknowledge Paul Fulcher, who is half of Lively-Fulcher, who is also with us here tonight, who deserves really quite a round of applause for this magnificent instrument. Paul.
Are you here?
And as you can imagine, even if you've got a vision and you've got a dream, and you might even have the beginnings of a support monetarily, you do need to have the person who sits where all the decisions must be made. Heavy is the crown, I guess. And we'd also like to acknowledge our current rector and the rector of this cathedral for many years, decades really, who also shepherded this instrument to this time. Monsignor Jameson, please. There are two people particularly who I'd like to mention who are not with us tonight physically, but I believe are here in the communion of saints. And that is the person who gave permission to begin this work and really saw the first installation, at least the beginnings of that. That was the former rector of the cathedral, the late Monsignor Quinn, who we acknowledge tonight as having gotten this thing started and had the vision and the courage to do that. So we want to keep him in our prayers. And also someone who you may not know, but who was very instrumental in my deciding to really push this project through, and that would be Bob Barker, who was an assistant in the Office of Worship and a significant contributor to this organ financially as well. And so we want to remember Bob Barker in our prayers and thoughts tonight. His brother still contributes to the fund. I don't think Bill is here today, but he's in Pennsylvania. But we want to thank all those, and all those who are listed in our program. And there's a note there, if you're here tonight and you contributed and we didn't catch that, we'll rectify that at the end for our next program. Speaking of the next program, September 20th, October 16th, I think, or close to October 20th, and then November 16th. It's in your program. Those are already listed. Those are three of the next 14 events related to this instrument. So we have a full year ahead. For tonight's service, I want to thank the ushers who volunteered to be here tonight, and the wonderful readers, and those who've prepared a lovely reception in the Great Hall. We don't always open the Great Hall for a big reception. It's just beyond the door to the right of the cathedral, and it won't fit all of us, but it'll hold a lot of us, and there will be hors d'oeuvres and some champagne and lemonade and water and lovely treats. So we hope you can join us for that, and we want to thank Maria da Silva and Belinda Barahona and Knockley, who are helping coordinate all of that in there for us. So that is it. I just want to say this. Half of the joy for me of this night is that we were able to do this for our cathedral organist, who I know was so anxious to see this happen and really wondered if it ever would happen. And really a tremendous, essential part of our music ministry here, who you'll hear at the end and also in a concert next fall. The wonderful Paul Hardy. You can see him after in the reception. You can greet him at the reception. Now let us sing.
When long before time and the worlds were begun, when there was no earth and no sky and no sun, and all was deep silence and night reigned supreme, and even our Maker had only a dream. The silence was broken when God sang the song, and light pierced the darkness, and rhythm began. And with its first birth cries, creation was born, and creaturely voices sang praise to the morn. To you, God the singer, our voices we raise. To you, song incarnate, we give all our praise. To you, Holy Spirit, our life and our breath, be glory forever through life and through death. Amen.
Tis good, the Lord. come and join over there.
Hi, everybody. I got bells.
Okay, there's a key going down, and there's one bell that goes down.
Okay.
Disorder, it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be different.
Yeah.